Yeah, my association with the computer industry started in 1978 when I was assigned the task of computerizing the operations of Bank of Ceylon. My selection to head the computer division at Bank of Ceylon was prompted by the fact that I was young in age and had some previous exposure to computers. When I took over the project in 1978, an order had already been placed for a computer system, which was an IBM System 34, having main memory of 128K and 128 megabytes of hard disk. The emphasis at the time of selection had been to provide support to the finance function for the generation of financial reports as well as reports for the central bank. I had to start from scratch, and my first step was to recruit a competent DP manager. The bank was fortunate to attract one of the most eminent computer professionals to take up the post, that is Dr. R.B. Ekanayake. So we started with the foreign trade side and successfully implemented the automation of the letters of credit process. Now this was a real breakthrough. It was extended in stages to cover further levels of automation, such as generating the telex messages to be dispatched to the correspondent banks and so on. I think at this stage I must mention contribution made by Dr. Ekanayake, because all the work was done under his direction. Or my role was mainly to provide the vision and the direction. RB and I discussed among ourselves and was able to connect the Bank of Ceylon new head office building with the old building at York Street on telecommunication lines. I got an offer from the Sampath Bank to set it up and start the operation from there in 1987. And I was again fortunate to persuade Dr. Ekanayake to join me in the effort. We were able to get the system ready in a period as short as 7 weeks. Sampath was the first to have multi-point ATMs. Before Sampath, the banking hours in the country was 9 to 1 p.m. on Mondays and 9 to 1:30 p.m. on the rest of the weekdays. Now, at Sampath, we extended the banking hours from 9 to 3 p.m. Another interesting thing which I might mention is that this was a time when laptops came on the scene, and I had a laptop for myself, which I was able to communicate with the system through the use of my telephone line at home on a dial-up modem. And I used to monitor the availability of ATMs from home after dialing up and accessing the system. And sometimes I could, if a particular ATM is offline, I could activate from home. So this is also some breakthrough which we made at the time. In 1995, I joined Union Bank, and the Union Bank was the first to do away with the branch concept. The customers of the bank and not of a particular branch. There we introduced phone banking. Here again, I must say that Union Bank was not the first commercial bank under the guidance of Dr. Ekanayake, was the first to accomplish the task, but we were second. But of course, Union Bank, we were first to have a presence on the internet with the bank's own website. Then we were the first there to introduce internet banking. Then another innovation we introduced at Union Bank was email banking.